It's 2025, and people still think their Wi-Fi is unhackable. Today, I'll show you what still works, what got patched, and how real attackers adapt. Before we dive into the technical side, let's get one thing straight. Wi-Fi security has evolved, but so have the techniques used to break it. The cat and mouse game between security researchers and hackers never stops. Some of the methods that worked a few years ago are completely useless now, while others are still shockingly effective, and of course, new techniques are emerging as defenses change. This video is for educational purposes only. Don't use this knowledge for illegal activities, or you'll end up on the wrong side of the law. Now let's talk about how Wi-Fi security has changed over the years. First, we need to understand the differences between WEP, WPA2, and WPA3. WEP is ancient and practically useless. It's like locking your door but leaving the key under the mat. WPA2 has been the gold standard for years, but it has weaknesses, especially against brute force attacks and deauthentication exploits. WPA3 was introduced to fix these flaws, but adoption has been slow. Many devices and routers still don't support it, meaning WPA2 remains the most common standard in use today. This is important because while WPA3 introduces protections like simultaneous authentication of equals, most networks are still vulnerable to old tricks. Before doing anything, you need the right tools. First, a wireless network adapter that supports monitor mode and packet injection. Most built-in laptop Wi-Fi cards won't cut it, so you'll need something like an Alpha AWUS 036ACH or a similar adapter. Next, you'll need a Linux-based OS like Kali Linux or Parrot OS. These come preloaded with the necessary tools, saving you a lot of setup time. You'll also need software like Aircrack-ng, MDK4, BetterCap, and Hashcat. To check if your adapter supports monitor mode, run the command iwconfig. If it says monitor mode, you're good. If not, time to get a better adapter. To hack Wi-Fi, you need to understand how the attacks actually work. Deauthentication attacks, for example, work by kicking a device off a network, forcing it to reconnect and exposing its handshake in the process. This is still effective against WPA2, but WPA3 has measures to mitigate it. Monitor mode lets you capture all network traffic without connecting to the network. Then there's the evil twin attack, where attackers create a fake access point that mimics a real network. When victims connect, they unknowingly hand over their credentials. Devices are programmed to auto-connect to familiar networks, and attackers exploit this by setting up a clone of a trusted Wi-Fi name. Now, here's where things get interesting. Most people think they understand how these attacks happen. Firewalls, antiviruses, all the standard defenses. But in reality, the landscape is constantly shifting. What worked yesterday might be useless tomorrow. And that's exactly why hackers keep winning. See, the real problem isn't just outdated security. It's the mindset. Companies patch what they see, but ignore what they don't understand. And that gap, that's where things get dangerous. The craziest exploits aren't always about complex zero days. Sometimes, it's the simplest oversights that lead to complete compromise. The kind of things that, if you knew how they worked, you'd never look at security the same way again. I'd love to break it all down here, show you the exact attack chains, the real-world breaches, the kind of stuff that makes even the biggest companies nervous, but I can't. Not here. Every time I get into the real details, YouTube steps in, videos get flagged, restricted, buried, and I'm not about to water things down just to keep them online, so if you want to see how these attacks actually play out, the payloads, the exploits, the defenses that fail when they shouldn't, you know where to find it. First link in the description. Let us start with the classic method, capturing and cracking WPA2 handshakes. First, put your wireless card into monitor mode with AirMon NG start WLAN 0. Then, scan for available networks using AirDump NG WLAN 0 MON. Once you have identified the target, filter the capture to focus on that network. AirDump NG-C channel --BSSID-W capture WLAN 0 MUN. To force devices to reconnect and capture a handshake, use MDK4 WLAN 0 MUN-D-E target SSID-C followed by the channel. Once you have the handshake, you can attempt to crack it using a dictionary attack with Aircrack-ng-W wordlist-B-BSSID capture-01.cap or a GPU-based brute force attack with Hashcat. But what if the password is strong? That is where evil twin attacks come in. Instead of trying to crack the password, we trick users into giving it to us. Then redirect victims to a fake login page using BetterCap or a custom phishing portal. When they enter their real Wi-Fi password, you capture it in plain text. This attack is especially effective in public places, where users do not think twice about connecting to an open network. Now, let us talk about what is patched. If you are still trying to crack WPA3 with old handshake methods, forget it. Simultaneous authentication of equals SAE eliminates traditional handshake vulnerabilities, making brute force attacks almost impossible. Randomized MAC addresses on modern devices also make tracking and targeting harder. Many routers now have built-in protections against deauthentication attacks. The bottom line? Do not waste time on outdated methods. So how do real hackers still break into Wi-Fi networks? They adapt. Instead of relying on brute force, they use social engineering and phishing attacks. Many people still fall for fake login pages or reuse weak passwords. Rogue access point attacks combined with phishing pages are far more effective than trying to crack WPA3. If you can trick someone into entering their password, you do not need to break encryption at all. To wrap up, some Wi-Fi attacks still work in 2025, but others have been patched. Traditional WPA2 handshake cracking is still viable, but WPA3 is much harder to break. Evil twin attacks and social engineering remain highly effective. The real lesson? Security is only as strong as its weakest link, and that is usually human error. If you found this interesting and want the unfiltered version of how these attacks really work in the wild, I cannot show it here, but you know where to find me. See you inside Cyberflow's Academy.